All right, it's Bill here. Here's my thoughts on a 5-4 loss to the Detroit Red Wings in overtime. Plus, I'm going to give you my thoughts on a 6-5 New Jersey Devils win on Thursday. I finally watched the entire game, and I wish I had not watched the entire game. I saw the little highlights at darts, but watching the game afterwards made me upset. But I watched it because I guess I've got a self heat to watch this nonsense. The Leafs have mailed it in when they had an opportunity to get home ice advantage and what would appear to be an opportunity to get first in the division. But no one wants that. No one wants that. We want to start on the road, Bill. I saw some comments for people that have entered. And I've heard the radio people, and you're all morons. You're all absolute morons. Before I get into the game, well, I'm going to say something. I was more upset watching the New Jersey game than I was the Detroit game. Because in the New Jersey game, we had primary assists for the other team. Meaning we passed it to the person who scored the goal. At least in this game, it was secondary assists or dumb pinches or stupid penalties that led to all of this. At the end of the day, we're preparing to get, we're the last couple games, I think I've heard Sheldon Keefe talk about preparing to get ready for the playoffs. Woo! I guess goaltending and defense is not a way to get prepared for the playoffs. Playing tight hockey, battling out there, that would appear not to be getting ready for the playoffs. Loosey-goosey, don't give a crap, don't try. If that's what we're trying to do to get ready for the playoffs, we are succeeding beyond belief. Well done. So before I get into the games, again, it's crazy how many times we hand... Not only we're handing the puck over at the blue lines, we've now decided we're going to give the puck away at our own goal line. Ooh, just change it up a little bit, eh? Defense is dreadful. Who's the guy who said that I'd prefer Wall as the goalie over Samsonov? Would that be me? This guy right here? Oh, I don't want my goalie swimming around all over the place. Should we make another call to Samsonov's dad? Because this guy can't stop a puck. But Wall's the problem. Anyways, for you morons that talked to me about not wanting home ice advantage and the fact that the Leafs have mailed it in for the last 10 games and haven't tried and Nylander hasn't even taken a step forward. Like, his effort on Simon Edvinson's goal tonight is of spectacular ability. Oh, did you pass it? Oh, should I follow you? Oh, no, you got a return pass? Oh, you scored? Oh, great move, Nylander. Let's try out three lines that we've never tried out before. Well, that makes sense. Let's put Nylander with Marner and Tavares. Yeah, how'd that work out? Even putting Nylander and Marner, two decent offensive hockey players, Tavares is going to sap that line out. That line's getting sapped. Would anyone like to know the last time that the Toronto Maple Leafs won a playoff series where they didn't have home ice advantage? For all you brainiacs out there. Anyone want to know? Got guesses? I'll give you a hint. The Leafs swept the team. You might go, Bill, when's the last time that the Leafs swept the team? A long goddamn time ago. Let me help you out with that one. Guesses? I'll give you another hint. Matt Sundin scored the overtime goal in game one to win the game. 1-0. Still guessing? The year was 2001. I think I was 23 years old. Look at the hair on my head. It's gone. The gray hairs in my beard, they didn't used to be gray. You'd be surprised they didn't used to be gray. The Leafs have not won a playoff series starting on the road since 2001. This happened before 9/11. we shouldn't play for home ice advantage. We should just try stuff out, not try anymore, and just accept being on the road against Boston or Florida in the first round. Huh. Did thoughts go through my head? How did we do in Boston when we didn't have home ice advantage in game 7? How'd that go for us? Oh, did they put Patrice Bergeron and Brad Marchand out against Jake Gardner? No way. No way. That couldn't have happened. Because we had home ice advantage. We would never have that matchup. Oh, yeah, it did. Didn't Jake Gardner go like -4 in one of those games? But you don't want home ice advantage. Oh.
But Bill, they only won one playoff game against the Tampa Bay Lightning on the road. They only won one against Florida on the road. They didn't want nothing at home.
It's because the Leafs are just not a good team. But don't tell me you don't want home ice advantage. That makes no sense on any level of anything. You think it's better to start off on the road? The Leafs team. Okay, I'm going to help you out. I'm going to give you some stats. Since 1993, the Leafs, when they have home ice advantage in playoff series, are 9-9. While that sucks, because it does suck, it's better than when they didn't have home ice advantage. Their record when they don't have home ice advantage since 1993 is 2-9. 2-9! They beat Detroit in 93 because Nick Borshevsky had no spleen or orbital bone and tipped in a shot from Bob Rouse, thanks to great play by Doug Gilmore and Wendell Clark to get the puck back. Passion Returns, watch it. 1993. You're probably too young. 1993. And the Ottawa Senators beating them 4-0 in a series sweep. That's it. That's all. That's all, folks. They have not won a playoff series on the road since 2001. Without home ice advantage, since 2001. So what I've seen with this bullcrap of trying things out and not trying in the game has cost the Leafs any chance of having home ice advantage. And it nearly, if they would have played half decently and won some games, they'd actually be going for first place in the division. But why care? Let's try stuff out. Let's put the fourth line out against Kucherov. Well, that makes sense. Let's try it out. See if it works. Yeah, try it out. See if it works. It don't. Don't work. If I get into this game today, this is the great synopsis of the Leafs. Okay, they get a first period goal by Mitch Marner. Nice pass. It was Nylander who made the pass. On the power play, you're up 1-0 in not less than 2 minutes after that. Morgan Riley has a brain fart, stupid garbage, overrated defenseman, decides to pinch, gets caught on a pinch, it's a 2-on-1. Now, I nearly crap because I'm like, is that Riley and Brody together? Well, the reason why Brody and Riley were together was because Liljegren got hit from behind. And I thought there was a guy on the team that was supposed to stop that from happening. I thought there was this guy, like 75, who kisses his muscles. Like when he comes on the ice, you ever see him? He comes on the ice, he goes, look how tough I am. Can I take an interview with my shirt off? Because I'm a tough guy. Joe Valino completely cheap-shotted Tim Liljegren, or Timothy Liljegren. I saw Nick Robertson go in. I think Nick Robertson probably comes up to my kneecap. But he went in. Where's our tough guy? Where's this guy that was going to stop that from happening? Later in the period, they were on the ice together. Valino and Reeves were on the ice together. And Nice took a friggin' penalty. Where's Reeves holding Valino responsible for that? Oh, I must have missed that when they paid him $1.35 million to kiss his muscles when he comes out and act like a fake tough guy. I must have missed it. Something must have happened there. Way to hold them accountable, Ryan. It's beautiful. That's exactly what I expect out of you. Just like when you were playing against Gudas and you didn't do anything to Gudas. You talked in the summer when you're on a golf course about how you're going to hold the... Yeah, no one cares, bud. You're a joke. You just watched a guy cheap shot your player, completely take his hand and push him from behind head first into the boards. Now, you should have got a boarding penalty for 5, but I don't even care. You got 2 minutes. Who cares? You have a chance to hold him accountable, and you don't. But I think Reese had a fantastic game. He must have scored a lot of goals because, you know, we want to keep him on the ice. Very important to our team. Very important, Reeves, to our team. 0 goals, 0 assists, 0, 0, 0, 0. 8 minutes and 17 minutes. Yeah, okay. Great game, Ryan. Way to hold the other team responsible for cheap-shotting us. I can't wait till the playoffs when Sam Bennett takes Matt Nye's head and rams it against the ice. You'll be there to handle that stuff. You'll be there. I'll wait with fainted breath. Anyways, Morgan Riley, horrible pinch, and then the William Nylander show happened where he didn't even try at all. I mean, like, you could not put less effort forth. You couldn't. Like, I don't know if there's a Back to the Future DeLorean where you can go back into the future with less effort. But, like, he'd be the Doc in that one. He put no effort forth. If there was an effort factor, he'd be like 0.000. What is the animals? What is your score, Butowski? 0. A pint. 0. That's the amount of effort he put forth. Edvinson got the passing and then get the give and go, and Nylander mailed that one in. And then Nylander killing a penalty. Last time I checked, the hardest working guys on the team should be killing penalties. Last time I checked. That would not include Nylander because that man doesn't work. He's just signed his contract. He's done. He's done. I'm out. I mean, I've watched this guy play for 30 games. He's been awful for 30 games. Not effort. Doesn't go to the net. He used to go to the net before the contract. He used to go to the net. Now he doesn't even know where the net is. Play on the outside. That's what he does. Yes, he'll get his goals and assists. Wait till playoff time. You got to go to the net. Anyways, I forget. DeBrincat scored 3-1. And then, again, horrible goaltending by Samsonov for the fourth goal. It goes 4-1. This is disaster. The Leafs played a really good second period, and it included Matthews getting his 69th goal. Of course, got Nick Robertson gets the second goal. Flies through the team, but you know Nick Robertson ain't playing a game in the playoffs. You know, because we got to put Ryan Reeves in there, the guy who holds people accountable. That guy's got to get some ice time. But the guy who can actually score goals and actually contribute to a game, that guy will not get any ice time. He'll be in the bench. Being told, you know, it's a tough break that you're in the bench there. But we got to put this Ryan Reeves guy on who, like, lets people hit from behind and doesn't hold him accountable for the entire game. We put that when the game doesn't matter. Apparently the game doesn't matter because we don't care about home ice advantage. That was clear. So maybe that would be the time to take out Joe Foligno. Just thinking out loud. So Nick Robertson scores. Thanks, Nick. It won't see in the playoffs, unfortunately, but thank you. That was really, really nice goal. 4-2. Matthews makes it 4-3 after a high stick and call to Kane. And then he should have scored the fourth goal. Nylander finally put an effort forth. He knew he took out Matthews for the rest of the season. That was great effort. He was floating behind the net while Matthews was doing a breakaway. What was Nylander doing behind the net? What was he doing there? When you go to the net to look for the rebound? No, but he was too busy floating around the boards. When Matthews got up, I nearly lost my breath there, but Matthews got up because that's hope. That's the only hope we have. And then Tavares, one of the worst goals I've ever seen. I've never seen a player can't skate so much that he, like, you look like, you know, when you're playing on the hockey in the hotels, when you stick hockey and you really lean into one, but you can't really run very fast because you're on your knees. That's Tavares. He's playing. He got a nice little pass. He went and went in the net. 4-4. And the Leafs played a horrible third period. Should have came out in the third period and buried him. But they didn't. And it wouldn't have been nice to get... And it was just trying to feed Austin Matthews' show versus trying to win the game. I get it. You want to get him 70, but let him get it naturally. He's a pretty good player. He can fight, figure it out. And it would have been nice to do it against James Reimer, who, by the way, I like James Reimer. I loved him as a Leaf. We effed up. That was the Dave Nonis eff up. We blamed him for the loss against Boston when we didn't realize that Jake Gartner had the primary assist on the OT winner by Patrice Bergeron. He passed it to him, and Dion Phaneuf didn't go anywhere near the front of our own net to clear it for the first two goals. But we blamed that on Reimer. We went and got Bernier. And how has that worked out for us? We went how many years without making a playoff run? Well, Bernier never got us to a playoff game, okay? Reimer did. Bernier didn't. This organization, I swear to God. If you can make a blunder, they will. Anyways, late penalty. Dylan Larkin makes it 5-4. Detroit still has an opportunity to get in the playoffs. Who cares? The Leafs play two more games. Probably is going to all be focused on 70. At the end of the day, the Leafs have mailed it in. If this is getting ready for a playoff run, you got to be joking me, right? You've given up 6 goals and 5 goals in the last 2 games. That's getting ready for the playoffs? Wow. Against two teams that probably won't make the playoffs. You gave up 11 goals against two teams that haven't made the playoffs or won't be making the playoffs. I'm supposed to be happy over here. I'm supposed to be enjoying this. But, Bill, don't worry about it. It doesn't matter. It's meaningless hockey right now. Home ice advantage, schmo ice advantage. 2001, the last time we won with a on the road. Now, I will say, regardless, we had home ice advantage or not home ice advantage, we're going to lose. But it's still better to have home ice advantage. I don't buy the bull crap that everyone sent in that. Anyways, what are we going to do? I'll watch Tuesday and hope that Austin Matthews gets 70. Woo. Cheers.